Yeah. And we call these Aunt Lena's peppers because Aunt Lena was the one that made sure this recipe got passed down, and she taught everybody. Aunt Lena taught my father's mother, and my father's mother taught my mother, and my mother has kept it passing down to us. So we're trying to keep this recipe alive. We believe everybody deserves a really great hot pepper and oil, and this is how you make them. They are a little labor intensive, but they're worth it.
We use a bushel of Hungarian hots, wax peppers, and we cut the tops off of them and scoop out all the seeds and then slice them in quarter inch slices.
Rings.
Like rings, and we put them in a crock, and probably every 3 inches of peppers, you put in a layer of salt. And for a bushel, you would only use the most, what, 1.5 to 2 cups of salt, right? Mm-hmm. And then
cup and a half of salt is the recipe that you've kind of you've lightened the salt load a little bit. Yeah,
we tweaked it.
Yeah,
and you put them in a old-fashioned crock. One bushel requires a 5-gallon crock, and you can press down the juices by having a wooden or a plate over the peppers, and probably the weight of 2 gallons of water, and press out as much liquid. Every day you pour the liquid off, and on the fifth day, and you pour the peppers out and add oil to cover. You add three tablespoons of oregano.
Yeah.
And 2.5 cups of chopped garlic. The garlic should really be chopped by hand, because when you use a
food processor,
it bruises the garlic too much, and it's not a good idea. And then you have clean jars, and you fill
pint
the
jars.
We use pints. Some people that I know today still do quarts, but we do pints. And you fill the pint up to the neck of the bottle, and making sure that the peppers are pretty well packed in, and the oil has to come up to the neck of the bottle. And you take a fork and go around the outside of the peppers in the bottle and try to see if any air bubbles come to the top. It's important to get air bubbles out if, in fact, there are some. You do need to get the air bubbles out. And you can leave them set for like an hour or so, and then go over the bottles. If the oil has gotten down, you can top it off and make sure all the peppers are covered, well covered with oil. And then you wipe the jars off with a very hot cloth so that there's no oil residue on the lip of the bottle. And just use a 2-piece lid, no sterilizing or anything. Just put the lid on and the screw top very tightly. And in 3 weeks, they're ready to eat.
I want to add that sometimes it's very difficult to find a bushel of peppers to make the whole 5-gallon crock. Well, you know, accordingly, you just use your calculator, and if you have like 3 gallons or 2 gallons worth of peppers, just take the 3 tablespoons of oregano or the 1.5 cups of salt and the amount of garlic, and you can always just adjust that for the amount of peppers that you have. Somebody recently couldn't get their hands on a crock, and they asked me if they could use an enameled pan to actually press the peppers in to get all the juice out. And I think that'll work out just fine, as long as the enamel's not chipped or anything. I think that'll work out fine. So you can use an enameled pot or also if you need to.
And if you use a crock, do not mix the oil and garlic and oregano in the crock. You do need to put it in a stainless steel or enamel lined pan. Never use aluminum pan. Something about the peppers that they'll just get wilted too soon. Not a good idea.
You know, we've been trying to grow our own peppers for this recipe for a number of years, and at the beginning years when we were learning how to make these from mom and my dad was still alive, we'd make the peppers and I'd be so proud of them, and my dad would taste them and he'd go, "Those peppers, they just weren't ripe," you know, and which is great. It was the input I needed. So it is very important that the peppers have reached their maturity and they're very ripe peppers.
Another hint is not to store the crock in a warm place. Everything has to be kept at a very cool temperature. Not refrigerated, but in a cool spot.
If you have a basement or a root cellar, these are good places to press the juice out of the peppers. And you pour the juice off every day. The first day there's a lot of juice, and then the successive days to day number five there's less and less, but I stay there and I take a long time on the successive days to get all that juice poured out as much as I can, so it's not sitting in these older juices.
And usually a 2 gallon container of water or whatever, or 2 gallon weights, mm-hmm. that will be sufficient for the 5 days. If you have to do it on the 6th day, that will be okay, but after that, don't waste your time, because they're not going to come as good. They have to
day 5's the day.
Day 5's the day, but if you want to rehydrate them and do them like early the next day, it'll work, but they're the best at the 5th day.
I think that's it. If you have any questions, call my mother.
My number.
Pasta, jam, chops, fump. Everybody eats when they come to my house. Everybody eats when they come to my house.